So our program is going to just take this very brief form. I think we are in the first one now, the welcome and introduction part. And it will be followed by presentation by Dr. Kazim immediately after I'm done with the introduction. And then we're going to have the question and answer session where you can, I mean, whatever questions you have can be addressed. There are a number of questions that have been sent in during the registration. So we're going to address those ones first. Then after that, we're going to address any other question that you may have. So we have with us this evening or this morning, wherever you are across the globe, Professor Dr. Muhammad Kazim Abdul-Jalil is the Director of Student Recruitment and Admissions Division at University Technology Malaysia. He's going to be addressing us. He's going to be answering your questions. Is going to be telling you about UTM and why you should study in Malaysia and in UTM. And after the meeting, if you have any question, he's also going to be addressing your questions. So thank you very much for joining us, Prof. Kazim. We are very glad to have you with us this evening. I'm going to make a co-host just now so you can make your presentation. If you're going to be sharing your screen, I think you can do that.
Okay, this is my name, Dr. Kazim. I'm in charge of admission and recruitment of all UTM students, including international. I traveled to Nigeria in 2018 with Steve and Bosidi. I really enjoy Nigeria, one of the countries that I enjoy to visit. Very friendly people, nice. The food is very, very good, Nigeria. Amazing. And we went
That's
to we went to Lagos and Abuja, Ede, Oshobo. There is another specific one.
Do you like Oshobo?
Yeah, Oshobo was not bad. And then Oshobo is nice. And then Ede, Oshobo.
I hope you had Amalanere too.
There is another one, Bosidi. Your city. What is it called?
Oshobo. Also in Ibadan.
Exactly. Ibadan was interesting. So I really like Nigeria. And for your information, we have around 400, I think 400. Slightly more than 400 Nigerian students in UTM, mostly are doing PhD and masters, and very, very few doing degree or bachelor with UTM. Mostly are TED Fund and Petroleum Fund scholars, and we have a small number of private students. Okay, I pretty much know a lot about Nigeria. Okay, I will show you some pictures so that you get some, you can imagine how UTM looks like, yeah? Okay, next page, please. Okay, this is, you see, at the end of the day, you will be taking picture in one of the, what do you call this?
Convocation.
Yeah, convocation in front of the library. Once you get your degree, you can say I'm UTM. You'll be part of us, yeah. And then next one. Okay, this is the gate, and the weather is exactly like Nigeria. I would say Ibadan
is similar. Yeah, very similar to you. I get.
It's a little bit dry. It's green. Green as the middle part of Nigeria or southern part of Nigeria. And next one, this is the picture, the evening picture, just before sunset. We have a mosque in the middle, and the campus is quite big, 1,400 acres, if I'm not mistaken. If you jog, if you run from one gate to the other, it will take you 7 kilometers. So quite a distance. And it is fully guarded and gated, security. And public cannot enter without leaving behind their ID or their name. So you are secure basically if you live on campus. Yeah. Okay. Another picture. UTM. The mosque. The mosque is in the center. We have Malaysia. If you are not familiar, Malaysia is in Southeast Asia, one of the fastest growing region in the world. We are in the middle, in between Singapore and Thailand. It is a peninsula. We have west part of Malaysia and east part of Malaysia. If you study in UTM, you can travel to Indonesia within 1 hour by boat. Or you cross the bridge to Singapore. Or you travel to the capital, Kuala Lumpur, by bus, by coach, another 4 hours.
Hello.
Sorry, hello. Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Okay. Pretty much our ranking, this was last year. This year we are ranked 183, if I'm mistaken. 183 on this. Just recently released, UTM is top 200. We moved 30 rank up, and basically we are now 180 plus in the world. And then in Asia, we are still top 50. So basically top 50 in Asia, top 200 in the world. And we have around 24,000 students altogether. Postgraduate, around half of them. PhD, 25% or 30%. Equal number of master's student. And international student, we have around 4,500 students from 75. More than 75 countries. It is a diversified community. You will enjoy the company of many, many international students, including Nigeria. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Pretty much. Yeah. I'll show you more pictures. I don't want to talk too much about the UTM. This is the picture. You can click Bosidi. You can click the picture. There is a small lake.
Okay, the lake.
Yeah, there is a small man-made lake just before the entrance of UTM, to UTM. So basically you can enjoy the scenery in the evening before sunset. And we have a lot of rain. Now it's rainy season. Our rain is really heavy. I'm not sure how heavy is the rain in Nigeria, but in Malaysia, the rain is very, very heavy. But we don't have flood in UTM, don't worry. Okay, we have a small campus in Kuala Lumpur, which is around, I think, 40 hectares, right in the middle of city center, 2 or 3 kilometers from Kuala Lumpur city center. Pretty much it is in the heart of Kuala Lumpur. We have a selected program running in Kuala Lumpur campus. It is a city campus. We have MBA, businesses, and sustainability, disaster management, education. I think selected areas in education like English, you can study in Kuala Lumpur, and the rest you can study in Johor Bahru. Kuala Lumpur campus is a little bit, it is small, but if you like city life, then Kuala Lumpur is your choice. If you like a little bit not rural, a little bit less congestion, less traffic, less crowd, then Johor Bahru is a nice city. Johor Bahru is the second largest city in Malaysia and border town to Singapore. Very, very close. Yeah. Okay. Why choose UTM? Okay, next. Basically, our degree is recognized worldwide. Be it engineering, education, anything. So you can take our degree, you can go work anywhere in the world. It is accepted. Nobody will question. Yeah. Partners, we have a lot of partners all over the world, in industrial partners as well as academic partners. So you are basically well connected to the world if you study in UTM. Okay, next. Okay, I will run through the area of study. Engineering, basically we have everything under engineering, from computer engineering until nuclear engineering. I know we have a significant number of Nigerian doing chemical and petroleum related areas because you are one of the biggest oil producing country in Africa. So definitely chemical or petroleum related areas is one of the interests of many, many Nigerian students. Yeah. Okay, next. Sciences, quite a big number of Nigerians are doing sciences in UTM, in chemistry, biology, mathematics, physics. So we have all many, many field of studies in the area of sciences. Okay, again, next, we have computer. Anything under computer or IT, you can have big data. Computer science, software engineering, networking, and so on. Yeah, and then next, business and management. You can business related human resource, land administration, entrepreneurship, policy studies, business studies, marketing, economics. So we have this area of studies in at PhD and master's level as well. Okay, next. Architecture, yeah, this is one of the interests, I think. And many, many Nigerian students are doing architecture or built environment related area. We have town planning, transportation planning, geography, geoinformation, landscape, architecture, construction science, many, many areas, surveying. Yeah, okay, next, education, you name it. This is one of the biggest graduate faculty in UTM. Bosidi can explain a little bit more. But she is one of the alumni, I think, in education.
Yes.
And, we have management, administration, measurement and evaluation, STEM, education development, educational technology, and anything, TVET, TESOL, and many, many areas of, you know, in education. Okay, just a little bit more pictures about our campus life. You go down a little bit. Yeah, more. These are basically in the evening, you can do a lot of things. We have stadium. I'll show you. We have stadium. These are basically research facilities. We have hotels. Three hotels in Kuala Lumpur, one library in Kuala Lumpur, two big libraries in Johor Bahru. So these are basically our libraries. And we have a stadium, yeah, a real stadium. This is not small stadium, it's a big stadium. Inside UTM, for UTM students, yeah. We call it Azman Hashim Stadium. Okay, you see this is the view. Inside, you can run, you can do whatever you like. Okay, we are not as good as Nigeria in football, but football is one of the game. Yeah, Nigeria is a world class. Malaysia is maybe third, fourth class division. Okay, swimming pool. We have a health center. You see, three ambulance standby 24 hours a day. The health facility is good. It is all included. If you are sponsored, it is free. If you pay, you just pay. If you are self-sponsored, then you pay just the fees, medical fees a little bit, not much. Okay, very, very low. Okay, and we have a dental facility as well as outpatient clinic. And then if you have inpatient cases, then we have our panel of hospital covered under your insurance. Okay, these are basically the medical facilities in UTM. Very convenient within campus, yeah. And then these are a sample of our hostel. It depends on your level of affordability. If you have good money, that fund, I think, provide good stipend every single month. If petroleum, covered by petroleum fund or something like that, you are rich man. Yeah, I heard get a lot of money, so that you will live like a rich man in UTM. Okay, so if you are there, so this is scholars in. If you have extra money, then you can stay here. Otherwise, we have a lot more option at a cheaper rate. for everybody. It depends on your affordability. Or you can live outside. Outside is also convenient. You can share with your friends. And Malaysia is very safe country. It's very safe. I think Bo Siti can share his her experience. And she has been living here for more than, I think, 10 years? More than that?
Eight years.
You will enjoy your stay in Malaysia. These are horse riding. There is a equestrian club. You can join as well. Okay, I just click that video.
Okay.
Oh, can you? Oh, you cannot click the video.
No, it can't be clicked. No.
Okay. Further up. This is UTM Kuala Lumpur. On your right is basically the lecture room, a 10-story building. I think that more than that, maybe 12-story building. If you go on top of the roof, you can see Kuala Lumpur. There is a roof. Okay, it's not big. I took this picture. Okay, and then further down, that is UTM KL again. Okay, in the UTM Kuala Lumpur, you go down a little bit. Go up, not down. You show them the mall, not this one.
The mall. One, okay.
Yeah, the previous one.
This one.
Previous one. Okay. The previous one, not this one.
This.
Okay. No, the previous. Okay, this one. Okay. On left is basically UTM KL. There is this is one of the few universities in Malaysia that has a mall, right? On campus, basically it is a mall. You see the three towers connected to the mall are basically the hotels, residential area. You can rent a 2-bedroom, 3-bedroom apartment, a long-term stay, or you can rent a studio. You can share, or you can live alone. Depends on your financial situation. And behind that, basically, is the lecture hall. So it is very, very convenient. So everything is within walking distance. Yeah, that is UTM Kuala Lumpur. If you like to live in big city, if you don't, then I've showed you the picture of Johor Bahru. This is again UTM Kuala Lumpur. This is basically the center, the heart of the UTM Kuala Lumpur campus. Okay, again. Okay, we have a free bus service to transport you around, both in Johor Bahru and Kuala Lumpur, free. From 7 o'clock, I think 7 o'clock until 6 p.m.
10 p.m.
Yeah, 10 p.m. Yeah.
10 p.m. Yeah.
We have more than 4,500 students from 75 countries. Nigeria, I think number one is Indonesia. Number two is number two is Bangladesh, undergraduate mostly. Number three is Nigeria, I think, in terms of number. So you have a big contingent, mostly PhD and master student. They are all mature student coming from various government agency in Nigeria. Okay, so no worry, you feel proud to be in UTM. Okay, I think that is it. Pretty much my brief explanation about UTM. Forget about this, it's pro China. Okay, entry requirement. This is not entry requirement for you. You can skip this one. For master, we require 2.5 out of 4 if you are fresh graduate. If you have less than 2.5, we require 5 years working experience for masters. Yeah, for PhD, you just need a recognized master degree. That's it. Okay, so pretty much that is it. Very simple entry requirement for UTM. Okay, if you have any question, you can ask me now.
Okay, so I think we'll just go straight into the question and answer session. So I'm going to reshare my screen. I have some of the questions already on there, so we'll just run through them. Okay. So we're starting with these. These are questions that have been sent ahead when people were registering. So we just take them. And someone said, I have a OND and HND certificates only. Can I apply for a master degree at UTM?
HND is a British HND or higher national diploma?
Higher national diploma, Nigerian HND.
There is another one. It is called higher diploma in Nigeria, which is equivalent to master's.
Okay. No, that's a postgraduate diploma.
Okay.
Postgraduate diploma. HND, this is HND.
HND is below than degree. You need to complete your degree first.
So for those who have HND certificates, what options do they have to do a master's degree? What do they need to do?
You need to complete your degree, HND, before you can continue with your master's. HND so is basically equivalent to HND British, right? HNC, HND, British HND.
HND is like a bachelor's degree in Nigeria. Because they do 2 years of OND, that's the ordinary national diploma. Then they move on to do another 2 years of HND.
Okay.
Those are the group of people this question is.
After high school, right?
After high school. This is 4 years after high school. 4 years of study after high school.
If HND is equivalent to Bachelor of Technology or BSc,
yes,
you should be able to do masters. Yeah, you should do.
Okay.
I need to look at the certificate.
Okay. Okay.
You can email me later on.
It's okay.
We can
take a look. Yeah, the next question is already answered. And then someone asks, how many times can somebody defer their admission?
You can defer once. Basically, your offer letter is valid for 1 year. If let's say you apply for October intake 2020, because of COVID, we shifted the registration from September to October. Let's say you get an offer for October 2020 and somehow you cannot come, you can defer to February 2021 for free once. But if you say you want to defer again to September 2021, then you have to pay the processing fee again, because faculty normally need to relook. If you are PhD, they need to relook at the supervisor, whether the supervisor is still interested or not, this and that. So there is a processing fee for that.
Okay. How about part or full sponsorship, anything like that?
For PhD, we have a partial sponsorship, fee reduction. At the moment, IDF, it was released today, only 4,000 off for 2 semesters.
4,000 for 2 semesters. That makes 8,000.
No,
okay.
2,000 for 1 semester, 4,000.
Oh, okay.
4,000 ringgit altogether.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
That is for PhD only. For masters, no. You see, you have to look at UTM expenses in different way. Our fees is very low. It's not very, very high. For PhD, I think it's around, how much is that for? $15,000.
Okay.
Maximum $15,000 for PhD. Just for the fees, 3 years. You see, for masters is half of that. So 7,500 USD. That is for masters, which is where it is very, very low. The fees is reasonable. The quality is good. So the government has already subsidized around 40% of the fees.
So someone is asking, the basic requirement for MA in applied linguistics.
Master in applied
linguistics.
Yeah, you should have a degree in English or linguistic studies, And then if you don't have working experience, your CGPA should be 2.5 out of 4 and above. If you have less than that, we require 5 years working experience.
Okay. Application deadline for September and January intakes?
31st of July. For October this year, we extended 1 month. Normally, the deadline for September intake is 30th of June. But because of COVID, we shifted 1 month the deadline as well as the registration day from September to October. So for this year, special for this year, the closing date for October intake is 31st of July.
Okay,
for
January
is 30th of November.
Okay, so people can still apply now to come in for September intake.
Yeah, for October intake. PhD, you can come anytime. PhD or Master by Research, we call it MPhil, you can come anytime throughout the year. There's no, you come anytime as you like.
Okay.
You can come anytime.
Okay. And then, okay,
courses,
for...
If you take, you need to come in February or in September.
Okay. And then someone also asked, okay, now admission is still open, but then because of restriction of movement across the world, it's difficult to make arrangement for transcripts and other documents that they may need. Is there any concession? Can they apply with maybe unofficial transcript and then they can submit official transcripts when it's ready?
That one can be done if you have it certified by the what do you call it? Transcript must be certified by the school. If you can do that,
They couldn't reach the school. That's the problem. If they, that's why they couldn't get the transcript.
Because you see, the visa, you may have some difficulty with the visa application. The immigration will require you to have the original. The copy of original.
What if they can get the student copy or the unofficial copy endorsed by the court?
By the authority, then okay, we can consider.
Okay.
But you must bring the original during the registration.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. How much money do I need to have before leaving my country to study at UTM? Minimum.
Monthly for your studies. It depends on if there is no requirement for you to bring in money, but 1 month I would say at least 400 USD should be sufficient, right, Boside, for a single person?
For a single person, if it includes accommodation and I think less than that would be okay. Yeah, for a student living on a budget.
300 will be
on 300
the budget.
Should be okay. 300 or less should be okay.
50 side. But if you are good eater, this and that, and then you need a little bit more, maybe $100. Otherwise, 300 is sufficient.
Okay. Yeah. Can I bring my family along?
You can bring your family. But it is advisable to come alone first, and then your family can join you later.
Okay. Does UTM have any scholarship in the medical sciences? Scholarship and
no,
courses?
We don't have medical program in UTM.
Okay. Any study and work opportunities available to international students?
Actually, study and work is not available in for any international student in Malaysia. We don't have a study and work scheme in Malaysia as a whole. You cannot work to support your study in Malaysia.
Okay.
You can work, but that is for your pocket money only, not for surviving.
Okay.
No, Nigerian is exempted from English, so you don't need to sit for IELTS or whatever.
Not really,
if your result is good.
Okay, so you can study for bachelor's at any age?
Provided your high school result is good.
Okay.
Yeah, that's master's good. program.
Okay. Next question is, HND in engineering with over 10 years corporate experience. Am I qualified to apply for the MBA program?
I have to look again at HND. I don't really remember HND, Nigerian HND. I need to take a look at the qualification.
Okay. So we get back to
Errol's transaction for further information later on.
It's okay. I'm in my second year of bachelor study in my country. Can I transfer my study to UTM? What's the procedure like?
You can transfer, but we still look at your high school results as well as your average mark. So you can apply. For Nigeria, if I'm not mistaken, you must have a B in math, physics, chemistry, or if you apply for humanities, some humanities subjects. If you apply for computer science, you must have at least B. B3, I think. B3, right? In high school.
Yeah.
Minimum. Okay. So, in the required subjects.
Okay.
Tuition fee, upon arrival, before we activate your student status, you need to pay everything.
Okay. You need to pay for this one semester full payment. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Do I need to show proof of financial ability to study at UTM?
Not really.
Okay.
But you need money to you need to have enough money to pay for your fees, everything upon arrival or before you register. Everything has to be paid online.
Okay.
You need to transfer the money. Normally, Nigerian, either they are sponsored. Or they are self-sponsored. If they are self-sponsored, normally they will pay from Nigeria before coming here.
Okay.
Or upon arrival, go to the bank and pay before registration. So
okay.
Without full payment, we will not activate the student status. And then the visa for the student pass will not be processed. So
okay.
Our system is slightly different from the West.
Okay, a few of the questions that were just sent in. Someone said, can I come for a PhD in educational technology without an education degree? I have MSc in information technology and 10 years experience working as an e-learning technologist in a university.
I don't see any problem. Because education is basically general area. They may require you to have some, bridging courses only.
Yes, usually they have to take bridging courses in foundations of education.
PhD, no problem.
Yeah. What's the admissions? Okay. Then
we accept admission via distance learning as long as the degree is recognized by the government of Nigeria, we accept.
Okay.
We have a database called UK NARIC. We will refer that as our reference. If we don't have anything from there, then we will contact your embassy or your ministry for verification.
Okay. To Patrick Ketofo, there is no community health or MBBS in UTM. No medical courses. You can reach out to Arrows Transactions for maybe other opportunities. Is there an installment payment of tuition fee for PhD?
PhD, overall, UTM, the payment of fees is done every semester, basically every 6 months.
Okay. Any supply chain or logistics studies?
Yes. You can study supply chain under management or under industrial engineering. Up to you.
Okay. Yeah, I think so far those are the questions we have. Let me see if we have any other.
MBBS, we don't have MBBS, but MBBS I think is around $100,000 in Malaysia in general. MBBS and MD. The cost is around $100,000 for I think 5 years after high school.
Okay. So I think those are the questions we have. so far. I don't know if there is anybody who still has any question. You can just type in, or you can maybe raise your hand so that I can unmute you to speak. So we are just winding up now. I'm just checking for in case we have any other question. Yeah, I think so far those are the questions we have. Thank you very much, Dr. Kazim, for your time and for. Somebody's just sending in a question now. For PhD, do I need to get a supervisor before applying? Is it compulsory to get a supervisor before applying for PhD?
The university will get you a supervisor. You can apply straight away.
Okay, so I think that's answered. So once again, let me say thank you to Prof for joining us. Thank you for your time. We're going to release you now, and then we can have maybe a little more chat with our participants. So if there is anyone that still needs something to clarify, you're very free to hold on in the webinar. I'll be able to address a few of your questions. Like I mentioned at the beginning of the webinar, I'm a product of University Technology Malaysia. I've been a student there, I've worked there. So I think I should be able to answer a few of your questions. And for the person asking questions about educational technology, maybe I can give you a few more details. I studied educational technology in UTM.